Ocean Ambassador for India. Every time I am on stage, I have to assign people. I feel really honored and scared at the same time because my words are going to be there with you all and you'll remember me by that. So I hope that today, whatever message I am here for, I can give it that nicely to you all and you take back good memories with me and not bore you all with this speech. It's going to be short and sweet for all you guys. First of all, thank you, Hitler, for calling me here. It's always been an honor and a good time to assign you guys because it's the way you guys take it, the spirit is really nice. Every time I go back, the feedback that I get, it motivates me also that, wow, I have inspired so many people. So, the contest that I won, I'm the first Indian to ever qualify for this in the year 2016. In Malaysia, and I had 16 contestants all over the world, including USA, Netherlands, UK, and all the contestants in this kind of a beauty pageants are all divers. You have to be a professional scuba diver to be into the Miss Scuba International, and also became the first Indian to ever win this title, and I created history for my country in the year 2016. Dive changed a lot of things about my life, the way I used to think, the way I was as a person, and my perception about life. When you dive, it actually teaches you to face your challenges in life. It makes you very strong. It makes you a very different person because you see a world that is uncertain, that is not seen, untouched completely. And there are millions of life forms out there, the colors, the living organisms, and sharks, of course, which a lot of people are threatened about, that they eat you up. It's actually a myth that's been created. Sharks are harmless. And underwater world, it's same as how you are above. So unless and until they fear and they have that threat that, oh, something's going to happen to us, they don't really do anything to you all. So never fear to dive, or someone says, or don't go in the oceans or something. They really don't do anything unless you really harm them. So they're equally scared. For them, you are like an alien coming into their world. So they fear that, oh my God, what is this? They're breathing. Because we are the only people who have these bubbles formed. When underwater, the organisms they live, they don't really form bubbles. We are the only one breathing in that way. So, you know, they also get scared that what has entered, you know, who is disturbing our world. It's very peaceful. It's lovely. And I'm glad that I got this opportunity to go for this pageant, represent my country, because trust me, when your flag is up there with USA, Netherlands, and yours is like in number one, you just, that feeling is immensely beautiful. It's just out of the world. Like I still have tears when I talk about my country flag going up. That time I don't see I belong to West, I belong to South. It's just one part that's India for me, and that's not even my name, like Varsha Rajpa, it's called India, so it really gives me that pride. And for everyone who is, I'm a self-made beauty queen, I'm a model professionally working in good brands. I compete internationally in dancing, I'm an international level dancer, I'm a swimmer, I'm an environmentalist by profession also. So all these things came up to me by the belief that I never gave up. I was 25 times rejected from Femina also before I participated in beauty pageants. But my mom and dad always said that never give up on your dreams. If you're focused, if you know what you want, nothing can stop you till you break and you say that I can't do it. So I strongly believe that everyone who wants to be something in life, it's never too late. Like, it's the perception of the society that, oh, you're so years old, you know, you cannot really do things. But it's never like that. Even after facing 25 times rejection, and I was 75 kilos when I actually stepped into my first pageant. So with that, I came into top 10. And that's when I believed that if I don't break and I don't give up, honestly, nothing in life can stop me. So it's like, if you don't have a way, then make a way to achieve your goals. That's when life doesn't give up on you and they're like, oh, she's a fighter, he's a fighter. We really need to look and give what they really are seeking for. So I have always believed that unless and until you have that strong willpower to be something in life and to become what you dream of, nothing in life can stop you. So I'm really proud that I could do something for my country and achieve what I wanted to always. So I'm glad that I've had wonderful parents who have always supported me. They never said you don't have, you're not very exceptional looking, or you know, just a beauty queen, why do you want to be that? Because I remember when I told my dad that I'm done with my master's in environment engineering now, I don't want to continue in this line, I want to step into media. He just in one call, he's like, do what your heart says. You don't really have to work, you don't have to do what you don't want to do. So I'm also blessed to have such parents, but I'm sure that all our parents would do that if we believe that, if we show them that we believe in our dreams and we can be what we want to be in life. So for everyone, never give up on your dreams. Always be strong-headed in what you want and don't break. When you feel that you are breaking down and you're weak in what's happening, or you just feel like that, oh, I can't do this, I give up. Always look up and say that I'm alive still to fight this battle of life. So thank you so much and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Thank you.